Holmes Under the Hammer in 45 minutes on BBC One. Before that, more nervy moments behind the wheel.
Do you remember how scary this felt? Well, taking your driving test is one of the most frightening things you can ever do. And for those learner drivers amongst us, you'll know exactly what I mean. Well, on Mirror Signal Maneuver, you find out just what happens. Getting your driving license is no piece of cake, I can tell you. More than half the drivers that take a test this year will fail. From mounting the curb, to speeding, to not stopping at a red light. The big open road is a scary place to be.
Wait. That's where you go in.
And there'll be plenty of chances to see just how scary that is over the course of the series. Yes, we've been given unlimited access to learner drivers around the country.
These roads are nice when there's nothing on them.
From the moment they take their first lesson, right up to the day of their test.
God, I'm so nervous.
Plus all the stalled hill starts and 7-point turns along the way.
I hate cyclists.
So ease into the driving seat as we start the journey that is learning to drive.
Perhaps I'm making excuses. Perhaps I'm just, crap.
Today on Mirror Signal Maneuver, we meet two learner drivers who are both desperate to drive for the sake of their job.
Wheel.
If you can't tell your clutch from your choke or your hubcap from your heated windscreen, then keep watching as we stall, skid and emergency stop our way through surviving the driving test on Mirror Signal Maneuver. If, like me, you find the thought of reversing around a corner, clutch control or hill starts about as enticing as a cold cup of tea, then buckle up as we brave the fast lane with hopeful wannabes on their quest for a license to drive. And what a quest that can be. Taking a driving test is one of those milestones that most of us will attempt at some point in our lives.
Is it against the law to have children in the car when you test? Not that I can't get a babysitter on the day.
And as we now have exclusive access to test centres around the country, we'll be following learners right up to the day where a driving examiner utters those immortal words.
Now, that is the end of the test.
That's the end of the test.
That's the end of the test.
So if you fancy the idea of watching learner drivers, including me, put themselves through the nail-biting, confidence-shaking experience that is learning to drive...
Right time, you looked at that centre mirror, wasn't it?
...then buckle up and enjoy the ride.
Stop! Oh, just...
Ah, the open road and nothing but miles of driving in front of me. If, like me, that thought is enough to fill you with fear and dread and get you crying out for the next taxi home, then climb aboard, because we're about to get down and dirty with what it takes to master the automobile. Do you remember the fear you felt on the day of your driving test? Well, spare a thought for poor learner drivers like us. Taking your driving test has to be one of the scariest things you can do. And we're going to find out just what's involved on Mirror Signal Maneuver. Yes, we're back behind the wheel with exclusive access to learner drivers as they career their way along the highways and byways of learning how to drive. We follow our wannabe drivers from their first manoeuvres...
Pull in. When I say to you pull in, you pull in.
...right through to the nerve-wracking day of their real test.
I'm dreading my manoeuvres.
It's a rollercoaster ride of pavement mounting, engine grinding, bunny hopping adventure. So settle in, buckle up and prepare for the bumpy road towards getting a license.
Find out exactly what's the problem with me, Anne Robinson, tonight at 9 on BBC One.
She's almost as good as me, do you not think?
Some secrets are hard to keep.
Right now, I need to be there for 100%.
I know what's going on. I mean, I've got eyes, I can see what's happening.
Cutting It, the new series, Tuesday at 9 on BBC One.
Are struggling gift shops in desperate need of a new wrapping? Mind your own business at 11. But right now on BBC One, a driving test.
Do you think you know what's what when it comes to giving way at a roundabout? Are you easily confused by a box junction? Don't worry, you're in safe hands. Mirror Signal Maneuver, the show about driving that reminds us why learning to do it can be one of the most frustrating, hilarious, rewarding, frightening and ridiculous things we'll ever do. And in quite a few cases, why we need to do it again and again and again and again and again.
Yes, we're on the road again, manoeuvring our way around the highs and lows of learning to drive.
BBC One stuck behind a learner driver. Mirror Signal Maneuver next. Then three more homes go under the hammer. That's at 10.
Join the Thoroughbreds for Royal Ascot at York today at 1:40 on BBC One and BBC Radio 5 Live.
I am the god of all Daleks. Worship him, worship him.
An old builder's office with an enormous yard. It's ripe for a makeover, you just need a bit of imagination. Homes Under the Hammer here on BBC One in 45 minutes.
If the words emergency stop, reversing round a corner and driving test bring you out in a cold sweat, then Mirror Signal Maneuver could be just the therapy you need. The first ever Brit to pass their driving test was, wait for it, one Mr. Bean, who made the grade 70 years ago. Now, 1.5 million drivers every year will be in a room like this waiting to take their test. How scary is that? So, will the drivers on today's show follow in Mr. Bean's successful tracks or be booking in for a second go?
And when you consider that only 43% of learner drivers pass their test, that's a lot of second-time takers.
I kind of think it's relaxing to play music when I'm driving. Do they allow that on your test?
And being one of them, I should know. But what the numbers don't reveal is the amount of worry, time, money and hysteria that goes into it along the way. Until now.
God, I'm so nervous.
Try and relax a little bit.
I know, I should, shouldn't I?
So stay tuned to find out more about the whys, whats and wheres of learning to drive. From the very first moment behind the wheel to the nail-biting end of the test when the examiner announces...
Well, I'm sorry to say you haven't passed today.
You failed or passed.
And I'm pleased to tell you passed.
Oh, cheers, mate.
Today on Mirror Signal Manoeuvre, we meet 17-year-old A-level student Michelle Dady.
Nice to see you.
Not really, I don't like the sun.
She's desperate to pass so she can take to the road with the love of her life.
I just saw this for sale and I've wanted one for so long.
And whether or not she does will be revealed later in the programme.
The signal will be
stop.
Anything particularly you need to remember about it?
Mobiles and mint imperials are strapped down.
Meanwhile, dad of three, Darren Charnley, is hoping to break his unlucky run of three failed tests. Will he get to take his boys to their caravan in a car of his own? We'll be there to see if he's fourth time lucky.
Stop.
Move on out. I'm coming through.
And I'll be going full circle on the highways and byways of Essex, where Ricky's got me practicing my approaches, my exits, and my lane positions on endless roundabouts.
Confidently achieved, executed, I believe.
Loads of people need an incentive to get on the road. Once there's a goal fixed in your mind, you've got something to aim for. Learner driver Michelle Dady has gone one step further than most. She's pledged all her time, money and potential licence to the new shiny black and cream love of her life.
And here it is, a 1993 Mini Mayfair that takes pride of place in Michelle's heart and driveway. She may have a boyfriend, but this was love at first sight. It's just some little thing, crush. Not like
everything I do depends on you. Since I've had it, I've girlified it. I've got all my little fluffy things. I've got little band air fresheners because I'm quite into my music. So, yeah, I've made it mine. I just saw this Mini for sale and I've wanted one for so long. It's just sat here for about a year now.
And her motor overtakes all other interests. She spent 1.5 years and nearly £2,000 learning to drive. And once she can, she's got plans.
I'm hoping to have a bit of work done now. I want some stripes down the front, new bumpers put on because mine are a bit rusty. I need a CD player and hopefully to get the interior done up a bit as well, getting the seats look a bit nicer. Big as your
gorgeous. When she's not clocking up miles with her bull terrier Rico, it's Michelle's mum who takes her out on regular test runs.
My mum takes me out in my Mini. I don't think anyone else would trust me, really.
You know, it's fine, we have a laugh. It's a bit nerve-wracking sometimes, but fine, yeah. I mean, she's got a car, she might as well be driving it.
I think the reason I've been learning for so long is because I'm not a very confident person when it comes to driving, because I've never had a bike, so I've never been riding a bike, which is apparently similar to learning in a car.
And who told you that, Michelle? Anyway, with two part-time jobs on the go to pay for all this, she's really had to give up a lot.
Due to my driving, I'm having to sacrifice all my lovely girly designer clothes that I like buying. I want a new tattoo, which I can't afford, and I can't get all my girly makeup that I want.
Michelle hopes to follow in her dad and brother's footsteps and pass first time, if only to spend some of that hard-earned cash on herself. But Big Brother Carl's witnessed her manoeuvres and isn't convinced of her chances.
I think she's putting pressure on herself to pass first time. We just wind her up about it because we know we can, so. But she brings it on herself with that.
Thank you.
She takes corners really close to the curb and just bounces around here, there and everywhere.
That isn't the sort of recommendation that's going to earn you a place in the hallowed car. Then again, college student Michelle is already considering a restricted taxi service, starting with her boyfriend, Jay.
I don't think many people can have a lift because they've got to be the same height as me. So I've been telling people that want a lift, you've got to be about 5'4" or no go. I don't think my boyfriend will get in today.
Love you, bye. For now, though, it's back to public transport. But I would walk 500 miles and I would walk 500 more. And remember, we'll find out if she passes her test and can finally take to the streets in her Mini later in the programme.
Hey, Mum.
Well, it may be a set of shiny wheels that's willing Michelle into the driving seat, but for dedicated dad Darren, it's all about getting out and about with the family.
Yes, when it comes to his family, 40-year-old Darren from South Manchester has a lot to give. Full-time cook, cleaner and carer to Pearl the dog, Delia and Priscilla the cats, and his three lovely boys. The only thing he can't offer them all is a lift to their beloved caravan in Blackpool.
we tend to go up to the caravan park most weekends, and then during school holidays, if the weather's good, then we'll spend most of the holidays up there as well.
If only he could drive.
It's just going to give us total independence. We'll be able to go where we want, when we want. There's going to be a lot more opportunities for the boys. In the holiday times and things when we're at home, the fact that we can just get in the car whenever we want, it's going to be great.
I'm free, do what I want, any old time.
It's freedom, isn't it? I feel so free when I'm out on that road. I'm not this person that's reliant on people to do favours for this, that and the other.
There's just one small problem. He's failed two tests and can't help but go to pieces when sat next to an examiner.
I'm not generally a nervous person. I get in the car with Trish, my instructor, and it's not a problem. But for some reason, this other person gets in the car with me and I make a really silly mistake.
It's something his instructor, Trish, has spent 18 months trying to cure and hopes he'll eventually overcome.
He's got the confidence to do it. No reason at all why he shouldn't pass this test. In the nicest possible way, I hope to see the back of him, but I don't really want to.
Trish is very much like a school mum. She'd have made a fantastic headmistress. She's just got that look, you know, and it's sort of the glasses come to the end of the nose, one of them, and it's like, no, we know we shouldn't have done that, do we? Yes, miss.
The car's ready to go. Darren's more than ready. All he needs now is his licence. In the meantime, they'll have to rely on other means of transport to get away for their weekend breaks.
Jump on board, take a ride, yeah. Jump on board, feel the high, yeah. Get through all right.
And remember, we'll catch up with Darren later in the programme to see if he makes it third time lucky with his driving test.
Mohammed.
In the meantime, I've been summoned to meet Ricky, my instructor, in deepest Essex. Now, why do I feel he's got something up his sleeve?
We're going to play roundabouts today.
No!
Your favourite.
Do you know what I was thinking? I really like Ricky, because we don't do roundabouts.
I'm afraid you're going to dislike me today.
I knew it. One of the reasons I failed my first test was because of roundabouts.
Nadia's had a few lessons with me now, and she's making fairly good progress. She has a very large problem with buses, which wasn't helped the other day when we nearly got squished between two of them.
That was extremely dangerous, that bus driver, wasn't it?
Her other major fear seems to be roundabouts, especially when there's cars on them.
And I think by the end of today, you'll be able to do roundabouts.
Do you?
Yep.
Come on, baby, let's do it.
I'm pleased with the way she's going. She's gaining confidence slowly, not quite as quickly as I'd like.
One more time.
This is my thing today. I'm going to be confident.
One more time.
Move on out. I'm going through.
Oh, yeah, on the outside, I'm telling him I'm super confident. On the inside, it's a whole different story.
Oh. Like that bit of curve there, did we?
This looks like my first roundabout.
Left at the roundabout, so check your signal left, that's it, cover your brakes. Now start looking as you come up to it. Now there's a lot coming, you're going to have to stop. So clutch down into first. Get some gas.
I think I can
go. And after the white one, you can go.
Confidently achieved, executed, I believe.
Yeah, check me out, I'm chuffed with that.
See, because I know me before, I wouldn't have wanted to go until that car was way, way out. But you have to start going, don't you? It's almost like you're going to drive into the side of them. Hello, Les. It's almost like you're going to drive into the side of them, isn't it?
Now, the thing that's always freaked me out about roundabouts is the approach. Know when to pull out, which lane to be in, when to indicate, and how best to exit. So, everything, really.
That's good. He's gone. Now we're going straight across this one, so you stay on the left-hand lane. Have your brakes. Have a look. Now that's your roundabout, because the truck's coming straight over. So
now do I indicate left?
Check your mirror signal left.
Going a bit fast.
And you should have been on the left-hand lane. You cut from the right, left to the right, and then back to the left again.
so. You were just being greedy there. You just wanted all the rounds.
Say hello to Noddy. Noddy! Hip, 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 hooray!
Yes, that is the Noddy song. Normally, I sing it with my daughter. Why I'm singing it now, I don't know. Maybe I'm feeling relaxed.
You know what's going to happen?
What?
All this confidence. I'm going to have a flaming accident.
Oh, spoke too soon.
Shush, everyone stop. There's a bus. What shall I do? Shall I indicate?
Go past him.
Stay there, stay there, stay there.
They're not as nasty as your buses down the road. They're nice buses here.
My confidence is really riding high now.
Yes. One more time.
Join me later to see if it stays that way or if I waver as Ricky directs me off the beaten track and on to country lanes.
Mmm, very pretty.
In Oldham, 17-year-old student Michelle Dady is about to take her last ever lesson with instructor Victor. Now, this pair have been together for a year and a half, and today's their diamond anniversary of sorts.
Love and marriage, love and marriage, go together like a horse.
That's 60 lessons to be precise, and with her test in just 3 days' time, it looks like things could get emotional. Maybe not. And when the spark leaves a marriage, there's always small talk to fill the silence.
Nice day, yeah?
Not really, I don't like the sun.
But that still means you have to concentrate, Michelle.
Well, oh, whoops.
Hang on, did she just hit that curb?
Whoops, that was because I was talking then.
Polishing my tires up a bit.
I was helping you out. Oh, I've never clipped a curb.
Well, first time for everything, isn't it?
Now, Michelle's been known to mount many a curb in her history of reverse manoeuvres. But this parallel park's looking good. Victor?
Fine, OK, Michelle. I suppose so.
I'm sorry, but I have to patch your car in the middle of Horseman Yard.
You're up this
way, aren't
you, Mum?
It's lucky.
And her reverse around a corner's looking spot on. Not that Victor's getting too worked up about it.
OK, fine. Move off and over at safe turn left at the junction.
But don't let this uninterested exterior fool you. Any minute now, he's going to spring into action. I can feel it.
Did you expect that? Not at the
last minute, no.
Told you?
No.
No.
Well, why did I? And you didn't then?
Because I was more concerned about whether the guy crossing the road was going to cross in time, whether I was going to squidge him.
Well, put it another way then. Why did you expect them traffic lights changing then?
Because they've been on green for ages.
Exactly.
I still didn't want to squidge the man though.
He's a difficult man to please, so considering it's their last lesson before her test, might there be a final word of encouragement from teacher to pupil?
Come a long way, Michelle, haven't you, since we first started?
I know. I can actually drive now.
Well, you see, that's what it is. I mean, now, you're not learning to drive anymore, you know, you're a new driver.
Oh, stop it, Victor, you'll make the poor girl blush. Back in South Manchester, full-time dad of three and man about the house, Darren Charnley, is about to take another lesson with instructor Trish. He's already failed two tests and is desperate to pass to take his boys on holiday.
Obviously, the turn in the road, the left reverse and the park. Left reverse we haven't done for a while. None of them are really a problem to him, but we just have to make sure that he's got the confidence to do it. No reason at all why he shouldn't pass this test.
And lessons come in useful when there's last-minute groceries to fetch.
I haven't told her yet, but I do need to call at the shop while we're out today, so... Well, she's used to that by now.
In the past, Darren's nerves have let him down when it comes to his test, He pulled out of the last one because he knew he'd failed. So how's Trish preparing him for this one?
The signal will be stop. Okay. Anything particularly you need to remember about it? At any stage.
Here's a clue, Darren. It's an emergency stop.
Mobiles and Mint Imperials are strapped down.
So, with all necessary bits strapped down, Darren's prepared for his emergency
stop. Well done. Drive off when you're ready, please.
And that's pretty near perfect. Under control, without skidding, and in the shortest possible distance. Still, with Trish, it's all about building Darren's confidence.
Good. Good. Well done. Good.
You got to accentuate the positive.
Stop whinging. That was much, much better.
Money.
Go.
Yes.
Well done. Good. Good. That's good. 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 You happy with that? That was good.
So, it's all good. Or is it?
I'd like you to use the next road on the left for a left reverse.
Now, this will require Darren to constantly check over his shoulder, and Trish has a handy tip.
Well, I always think the girl in The Exorcist would be absolutely brilliant at this. In fact, I'm going to make a sticker to stick on there that says Think Exorcist.
He'll have to tackle this like a man possessed. Now, Trish might have been joking about The Exorcist, but during his test, the examiner will expect Darren to continually check for other road users. So, if his head isn't rotating like Linda Blair's, he's not doing it well enough.
Right, okay, well done. So that was well controlled.
And if he repeats that on test day, he'll have nothing to worry about.
Keep going.
Which just leaves enough time for a quick trip to the newsagents before it closes.
Can you get me Manchester Evening News while you're there?
Of course I will.
Thank you. How you feel? Secure now? You've got your fags in your pocket?
I'm sorted now. Right. Yeah. And I remember to put the lottery on. So.
Are you ready?
Who needs to pass the test? I'll have a chauffeur.
Learning to drive is time-consuming and expensive. And one girl who knows that better than most is learner Michelle Dady. After a year and a half, she's still so keen to pass that she's dragged her mum out for extra practice too.
Come on, fix the gap.
Oh, okay then.
You ain't talking in my car.
Yes, it's Michelle's last chance for a drive before test day. And mum's doubling up as instructor Victor, who's booked up with other pupils. The trouble is, it's snowed, and Minnie hasn't got dual controls, and mum's not the most confident of passengers.
Minnie! No one takes me but you.
Are you going too fast?
Minnie!
In conditions like these, she's got to watch her speed. Then again, you can be failed for going too slow, as well as too fast.
Oh, I'm going fast. Mom!
We can get it in third now. Just...
I don't need third yet. It'll struggle in third. I'm only doing like 10, 15 miles an hour.
Oh! Oh, bit close.
Oh, that scared me. Did I scare you?
You scared me then, Shell.
Oh, I'm scaring myself.
I've got my foot on the brake.
There's no brake there, Mom. Not dual controls on it.
Now then, girls, don't get too chatty. Do that during a test and the examiner's likely to mark you down for not concentrating.
Oh, no.
Like now. Watch out for that milk float.
Michelle, slow down.
That was so close.
Nodding dog fell off.
I'll catch it.
She might have kept her head, but the nodding dog didn't.
My head fell off. Oh. He never hurt anyone.
What was that driver thinking? 10 out of 10 for hazard perception, Michelle. Luckily, she's in a forgiving mood.
What was she doing on our side of the road?
I know! No, it was her fault. Looking at me like, look at you, you little learner.
Quite right, Joe.
Don't you look at me that way. You know it's true.
You're doing all right. You've not stopped.
Don't jinx me, woman.
But it's not long before her mind is back on to more pressing issues. No, not her driving. It's what she's driving.
Who's one's looking at me?
Why?
Most probably looking at my sexy car.
Is it 'cause I'm cool
why you dress like me.
You know, what I've noticed being in this car is everyone looks at you.
Is it cos I'm cool?
Not a learner.
Yeah, but my car's sexier than that.
She's so caught up in her beloved Mini, she's having trouble with her directions.
I turn right, left here. I'm going to have to write on my hands which way is which, you know. I know it sounds silly, but I don't know.
I think you're going to have to.
That's right, Mum. Come test day, not knowing left from right won't be good.
I really don't know. I know I'm a left and right, but I don't, do you know, in quick situations, I can't work out.
Is it cos I'm fly?
Need to creep and peep.
And I'm not sure creep and peep is going to wash with the examiner either.
We're doing fine, aren't we?
Look at that. Look at that positioning.
I'm not
sure. Beautiful.
Oh, I'll have a cup of tea and a smoke.
Oh, I bet you do. The next time we see Michelle will be on test day. Still to come, Michelle buckles up for her first ever driving test. Will she and her Mini finally be alone together?
Signal will be like this. Stop.
Right, now, let's use that silver car down there, shall we?
Good thinking, Batman.
Darren has one last chance to prepare for his third driving test, but will it be his last ever lesson?
We're going.
Good girl, well done. That was excellent.
You know, I did that without thinking.
And I acquaint myself with the byways and grass verges of country driving.
You like that mud? I'm going to make you wash this car.
I don't know. It just doesn't seem to get any easier, this driving game, and there's always the looming of that dreaded day. Well, for Michelle Dady, the moment of truth has arrived. Her test is coming, ready or not.
I wasn't that nervous, but it might be different when I've got the test man in the car with me.
He's called an examiner, Michelle. And there's just time for one last pep talk from Victor.
Just want you to pretend that you're on a driving lesson.
Right.
I want you to be proud and confident, my young lady, of your standard. OK.
Now, road glare causes accidents, so when the sun's out, it's best to wear sunglasses. The bigger, the better.
I see your driving license, please.
There you go.
Thank you. Take your documents with you, please. And leave them as you go.
Okey-dokey.
Best of luck, Michelle.
Thank you. See you later.
Michelle sounds quite upbeat. Her examiner, Harry, takes her outside for the eyesight test. This marks the beginning of the test.
XA1 DND.
In 40 minutes' time, she'll know if she's passed or not. Since September 2003, candidates have been asked a general maintenance question, such as how to change a tyre and checking the oil level. If answered incorrectly, it counts as one driver fault. Michelle's nerves are beginning to show.
You don't mind if I tell you what I'm doing, do you?
That's fine, Michelle.
I'm a bit talkative.
That's fine, if it helps you, that's fine.
I'm just waiting for this van as well, it's coming a bit fast.
So she's pulled out well, and almost immediately the examiner wants her to pull over to the curb.
Quite close to the corner,
yes.
Oh, dear.
Oh, dear, that sounds like she's clipped the curb. Remember, she did that in her last lesson.
Well, oh, that was because I was talking then.
That'll be marked against her. It's not a good start. The examiner wants her to reverse around the corner. Here, she's got to continually check for other road users, as well as anticipate the curve of the road. She's turned, but is it sharp enough to get round? She definitely needs to have her steering on full lock to pull this off. And she looks to be doing just that.
Thank you.
Michelle's not yet halfway through the test. Back at the centre, Victor's apprehensive.
Depends what's out there. Depends on luck, really. She's confident. She's got the ability to act on what she sees. Michelle's got consistency. It's down to a lump of luck.
Now, very shortly, I shall ask you to stop us in an emergency.
Like this?
Yeah. Okay. Now, the signal will be like this. Stop. So when I do that, stop the vehicle quickly, safely, and under control.
Before she pulls off, she needs to make sure the road is clear. The examiner will choose his moment when it's safe to stop. On Michelle's part, this is the one time she doesn't have to check any of her mirrors before stopping.
Stop. Thank you. Now, I won't ask you to do that exercise again. Drive on your pedals.
Thank you. I only like it because it's the only time you can actually do bad driving.
Back on the road, Michelle's spirits are riding high. However, good driving relies on fantastic observation. Even when she isn't doing manoeuvres, the examiner will be looking for her to constantly check on the road ahead, use the mirrors to observe any road users behind, and anticipate any hazards, like that pedestrian.
He was leisurely strolling across the road. I sit with pedestrians today. The sun's going to the heads.
Victor's anticipating the end of the test, and I think he might be getting a little emotional.
Really, young people today, the confidence is brilliant. They're so polite. I mean, to think from my generation, I think the young people today are absolutely marvellous.
The test is almost over, and Michelle has minutes left before she finds out if she's passed.
Another log here on the left. Go in behind the next park car.
It's taken 62 lessons, almost £2,000 and 18 months to reach this point.
And stop the engine, please. Seatbelt off. That was the end of the test, Michelle. I'm pleased to tell you that you passed. Okay, so your driving license again.
You can. Oh my God. Oh, you're my best friend now.
My pupil has passed her driving test. I told you, this young lady. She surprised me. This is the fourth or fifth time she surprised me now.
I didn't even feel this happy when I passed my GCSEs A-level, so definitely very high up. Oh, guess what? You guess whether I did or didn't. Yes, I passed. Oh, yeah.
So, with no more lessons to pay for, Michelle can start to spend some of her hard-earned cash on girly clothes, that new tattoo, and, of course, her beloved Minnie Mayfair. Well done, Michelle. Meanwhile, back in South Manchester, dad of three, Darren Charnley, has just 4 days left till his test. He's determined to pass so he can take his three boys on holiday.
It's the one before the test where I go into this deep thought about things.
Oh, what's to think about, Darren? It's just concentration and focus you need. And today's chosen topic, the parallel park.
Right, now, let's use that silver car down there, shall we?
Good thinking, Batman.
Mm-hmm.
Which should be carried out with as much finesse and safe manoeuvring as possible. He needs to reverse straight back until he sees the silver car appear in the rear side window. Then steer fully to the left and reverse until the bumpers align. That's it, then steer full lock to the right.
We're going.
Straighten up, and it should be a job well done.
Come on, baby.
But nothing's ever that easy, is it?
Just touching the curb.
No, it just...
It's all right, so deal with it.
Now, remember, Darren, you're allowed to touch the curb, not mount it.
What are you going to do to deal with it?
We're going over there again. Come on, baby, down, get up. Wow, there's some super glue on this today.
Is it a bit
I'm
stiff?
I'm working up a sweat here.
Who needs the gym with a workout like this?
Quick straight.
Was that close enough?
That's about that far away.
It's all looking good. He's close to the curb, but a bit too close.
Is there a bump in this road?
It's called the curb. Right, start your engine again.
So he's just let himself down with a touch too much overcompensation. But there's nothing he can do about it now. The next time we see Darren, it'll be test day.
We did some parking today, which he coped with quite well. Started to go a little bit pear-shaped, but the good thing is that he knows how to put it right.
Back in deepest Essex, Ricky's got me winding along narrow lanes and through every pretty village and backwater going.
On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
It's all very nice, but there's one thing on my mind and one thing only.
So what are people like generally if they fail? Are they usually totally destroyed?
They're gutted, absolutely.
It's so expensive apart from anything else.
Well, it is. It's a lot of money to take the test. Plus, of course, you've got to pay for the car for 2 hours.
So do people cry a lot?
Yeah. Girls more than blokes. Blokes, you can see they're fighting it, they're holding it back.
Really? Yeah. Oh, does it break your heart?
Oh, it really upsets me.
Seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again.
I think Ricky's taking me on a tour of his favourite boyhood haunts.
This is Churchgate Street. This is lovely.
Very pretty.
And you know what? With my mind not on driving, my road handling's improving no end.
That was quite good.
That was very good.
I didn't get
good.
Too frightened.
No, you just swung through. That's brilliant. Good girl. Well done. That was excellent.
I did that. Do you know I did that without thinking?
You just reacted. Now, instinct again, you see. Your instincts are always right.
It's my instinct. I see his ugly head again.
Follow your instincts. They're always right.
Oh, yeah. I'll tell you about my life one day.
Now that would be a long story. Back to the subject in hand, Nadia, please.
So now this national speed limit applies.
That is 60 again.
But the national speed limit is 70.
No, 70 on a dual carriageway and motorway, 60 on a trunk road.
Oh, I see. I always think that sign means 70 miles per hour.
No.
I mean, I know it's 70 on a motorway and 60 on a dual carriageway.
No, it's 70 on a dual carriageway.
Can you tell that my theory test is all but a distant memory?
Yes.
Give it some gas on the bend when there's a car coming.
Yeah. Because you're on a hill, you're running out of power very quickly.
Yeah, I suppose so.
You like that mud. I'm going to make you wash this car tomorrow.
See what happens when I start thinking about driving.
Can you get off that white line?
Oh, great. A roundabout. I thought we'd left those behind.
What gear should you be in?
Second.
Yeah, not that one. That's it. There you go.
Ooh.
Right, where you go?
Should I go now?
Yeah, you go now. You suddenly
just
noticed there was a car there.
Just an emergency stop on a roundabout. You know what that is? I'm tired.
That's my excuse, and I'm sticking to it. And to think I've only got 2 more lessons till my test. Ah! No such luck for Darren Charnley. His third test is only minutes away, and he has to get it right this time if he and his 3 boys are ever going to get away on holiday under their own steam.
I'm trying to just focus on what's in front of me, and then hopefully I'll be coming back shortly with a good result.
And a test wouldn't be a test without the obligatory pit stop. And the waiting room isn't any easier third time. Today's examiner is Dave.
Okay, good luck.
Okay, right,
come on. Photo ID, please.
There you go.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Lead the way to your car, please.
Thanks. MJ04.
First up, the eyesight test, and then checking his knowledge of what's under the bonnet. He's off to a good start, but instructor Trish is worried about a mistake he made on his way to the test centre.
One time he stayed in the wrong gear, he was in too high a gear going round a corner. He knew he'd done it, He didn't do it again.
So watch your gears, Darren. And his first challenge is a T-junction. Here, the examiner will expect him to continually check for oncoming traffic and then wait for a safe point to pull out. It doesn't matter how long he has to wait for, as long as he pulls out safely at the first available opportunity. Oh, not like that. Oh, and there go the wipers. Now, keep calm, Darren. Stalling isn't enough for a fail in itself. Back at the test centre, Trish is anxious.
When he's nervous, he makes silly little mistakes. But he's had enough practice now to get over those. Hopefully we'll have a good result when he gets back.
Out on the road, Darren has been asked to turn the car around. Here, the examiner wants to see him make proper use of the accelerator, clutch, brakes and steering. He's good at this one. Smoothly, Darren. Smoothly does it. Oh, I forgot to mention that you're not meant to hit the curb. Whoops. Don't panic. Again, it doesn't necessarily mean a failure. And remember, it's perfectly acceptable to do the turn in 5 points. So, with a few minor corrections... Oh, watch that curb. And he's on his way.
Yeah, drive on when you're ready. Turn right at the end of the road.
He's almost halfway into his test. And now his road handling skills are under observation. Straight ahead on the carriageway is a cyclist. He's got to give enough room to get round him. And the examiner's marked him down for something. Keep it cool, Darren. Next challenge looks like another junction. Once again, Darren will have to wait for an appropriate moment to pull out at. Darren, stop! Oh, I think he's just avoided a collision, but only because the examiner's had to use the dual controls. He looks gutted. How am I gonna get through? How am I gonna get through?
What have I done to deserve this? What have I... Pull up on the left, just after this next driveway.
He's been under test conditions for 35 minutes now.
Just not being anxious.
And he won't have long to find out if it's going to be third time lucky.
Just give me a few moments to complete the paperwork.
If Darren doesn't make it this time, it will be devastating.
Okay, that's the end of the test. Do you want your instructor present at the conclusion of the test?
Yes, please.
So far, he's been learning with Trish for nearly 2 years. He's spent hundreds of pounds on lessons. He's got a car paid for and ready to drive. Is it all going to be worth it?
Well, that's the end of the test, Darren. I'm sorry it's not a pass on this occasion.
Oh, dear.
Oh, Darren, not again. Bad luck, mate.
I'll just run through the faults with you. Early on in the test, attempted to move off in second gear out onto the main road. And we
stopped.
We staggered to a stop in the middle of the road then, didn't we? Then we had speed on approach, some crossroads. We approached. I actually used the dual controls as we got there because we were approaching them too quickly and there was a car coming as we arrived at the junction. So we could have been in danger if we'd gone over the line. Got too close to a cyclist on the major road. I mean, really close to him.
God. Can you believe that? I can't believe it. I don't know what the hell I do when I get in there. It's like
you turn into a different person.
It is. Honestly, it is. I think I need to go somewhere where there's no traffic. There's no other cars, just me.
We will get in there, but I'm really, really upset for him.
You do a boo-boo like that in a big main road, and it was the same last time I did it then as well. What have I
done to deserve? And since this was filmed, Darren has gone on to fail his fourth test. But with perseverance, he'll get there in the end.
That's it. Another day of tension on the open road passes without too many incidents. See you next time for more beautifully mirrored, signalled manoeuvres.
Next time on Mirror Signal Manoeuvre.
You pulled out in front of them. I said, so we will wait.
We meet performance artist Nina Silvert, whose relationship with instructor Anne is pretty much on the rocks.
See, this is degenerated into a farce already.
OK, we're going to roll brake to stop, foot brake to stop.
In South London, 23-year-old graduate Tom Price has to pass his test to get ahead in his job.
OK, well, that's the end of your driving test.
And I get my head round the concept of the emergency.
Stop!
An accident waiting to happen, if you ask me.
Just ran over three cats, a pedestrian and a dog.
Will they opt to improve or up sticks and move? Let's hope they'll be staying put at 11 here on BBC One after Homes Under the Hammer next.
Three more unloved homes go to new owners at 10.
Wednesday night.
I wouldn't mind having a look at it myself.
Are getting warmer.
Is there a Mrs. Logan?
In Born and Bred, tonight at 8 on BBC One.
Yeah, you get welly boots when it's really wet.
The welly boots I picked up last year were nobody's business.
Wet conditions is entertaining, I must admit.
Wheelbarrow's completely full of Wellington boots.
We sold all of them for £4 a pair.
It's muddy, why do you got to wear wellies?
Flip-flops, just a terrible place for mud.
Stiletto heels are definitely out.
If anybody's short of wellies, you know where they got to come this year. I got plenty of boots.
Hello and a warm welcome to The Morning on BBC One, and it's the second day of Royal Ascot at York. So looking ahead, we'll bring you all the colour and spectacle at 1:40. But kicking off the morning, Nadia Sawala is back behind the wheel.
Be afraid, be very afraid. This is Mirror Signal Manoeuvre, the brake slamming, pavement mounting, non-stop rocky ride to getting a driving licence. Learning to drive is the one thing that I and loads of you have put off for years. But something usually comes along to force us out of hiding and into the driving seat. Whether it's the chance for a promotion, wanting to do more with the kids, or just being able to help out your nearest and dearest. In the end, getting behind the wheel is the only way forward.
Yes, learning to drive is definitely one of those life experiences that most of us can relate to. Whether going forwards, backwards, wobbling from side to side, or just drifting along in second gear, we've pretty much been there, done that. Ooh. And this is the series that brings together learners from around the country in all their engine shuddering glory. We've got wannabe drivers taking their very first lesson, right through to others in their 10th year of learning.
Second, one, two,
then left at the traffic light.
Some passing first time, others gearing up for test number 8. Just like life, learning to drive is never ever what you expect and always full of surprises. So pull out from the slip road, put your foot to the floor and join the fast but uncertain lane that is learning to drive.
Right, I'd like to switch everything off.
Today on Mirror Signal Manoeuvre, we meet performance artist and singer Nina Silvert, who's desperate to get to her gigs. But is her creative spirit getting in the way of her driving lessons?
You must approach the roundabout for